Tell him to cut it back to you. You got a hot date. Tell him you got a hot date for your brunch this afternoon.
Oh, well. He's retired now. He doesn't have anything else to do. Now you have to go for a ride on his motorcycle.
Ask Colin, see what he says.
Happy birthday.
He says a long-winded one.
Thank you. He said, oh yeah, I turned it on.
One thing she always had for her, morning.
Good morning.
Oh, good to see you. Look at your prayer. Oh, I gotta tell you, on Halloween this week, on Thursday morning, Pastor called and asked if I would cover for him, because he barely made it through the Wednesday night service. In fact, I think in the midst of the Wednesday night, just after he finished the sermon, he got the feeling to me. So he called and asked if I would take the service today. So if he gets a little disjointed, you say, yep, see, I had to announce it was going to be disjointed because you can't tell when it's disjointed on me. So anyway, Pastor is home, recovering. He did have to go see the doctor again. They told him what was going on. They didn't tell me yet what's going on, but he's going to be all right. But we are here without our headmaster. Okay? In your bulletin, you're not going to be listening. Talks about Eileen Butcher. And she has been diagnosed with colon cancer, but they're hoping that maybe they got there in time. So we'll find out tomorrow. And Ted Dieter is down in Iowa. I don't know where he's at in Iowa City, but he's in the hospital down there. Then I got to reading this thing. Man, I can announce the whole bloom thing to you. Everything on there is really pretty important, so be sure to read it. I like this little Reformation thing there. Be sure to read that. Adult Bible study, they worded it well. I like that. They said adult Bible study, you have to come back to study on the large catechism will begin when he gets around to it. Okay? Well, they did say that, as soon as he's able. But so there won't be any adult Bible class today. Up here, just reading that book. Oh, but that could get lost. Deacons, notice right at the top there, there's a little note to you. And then we have been reading this book, Being Lutheran, and I kind of thought it was going to be another catechism. Whoa, no, it is not a catechism. It is a very, very well-written book. And there you go, there's one over there. Do you have any left?
Lots of them left.
Lots of them left.
$13 at the welcome desk.
$13? Okay. Oh, it says so right there, 13. Yeah, good. So see, okay. Reformation, walking 500 miles, read that. Face of the Reformation, that's going to be new. So you might want to read that and watch for that. Oktoberfest, show of care. Just the point is, read it. If you don't read it, I got to read it to you. Oh, one more little thing, since I mentioned it in my sermon. Over on the next page, it talks about music ministry. And I just want you to wake up at that point and pay attention to what I'm talking about. Okay? If you are sleeping, catch your nap here. Okay. Otherwise, that's it. I think it'd be good if we took this moment right now to stand up and shake hands and pass the peace of Christ above. The owner of the application isn't even aware of it. But Bob Seedloff turned 95 years old. He doesn't look 95. More like 85. But don't you? Yeah. And we repent of our sins. So the Lord shows compassion to those who fear him. He showed compassion to us by sending his Son, Jesus Christ, who died for our forgiveness and rose again to bring us new life. Because of Jesus, God does not deal with us according to our sins, but repays us according to our iniquities. Therefore, as a called and ordained servant of Christ and by his authority, I forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. As far as the east is from the west, so far does God remove our transgressions from us.
Deliver me from my enemies, O Lord.
I have fled to you for refuge.
Hear my prayer, O Lord. Give ear to my pleas for mercy.
In your faithfulness, answer me. In your righteousness,
enter not into judgment with your servant.
For no one living is righteous before you. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Deliver me from my enemies, O Lord.
I have fled to you for refuge.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, our refuge and strength, the author of all godliness, hear the devout prayer of your church, especially in times of persecution, and grant that what we ask in faith we may obtain through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated at your knees. The Old Testament lesson for today is 13 chapters long. It's found in chapter 15, verses 15 to 21. When Joseph's brothers saw that their father was dead, they said, "It may be that Joseph will hate us and pay us back for all the evil that we did to him." So they sent a messenger to Joseph saying, "Our father gave this command before he died. Say to Joseph, please forgive the transgressions of your brothers and their sin because they did evil to you. And now, please forgive the transgressions of your servants of God our Father." Joseph wept when they spoke to him. His brothers also came and fell down before him and said, "Behold, we are your servants." But Joseph said to them, "Do not fear, for am I in the place of God? As for you, you meant evil against me, but God meant it for good, to bring it about today that many people should be kept alive as they are today. So do not fear. I will provide for you and your little ones." Thus he comforted them and spoke kindly to them. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The epistle lesson for today is found in the 14th chapter of Romans, beginning at the first verse as follows. "As for the one who is weak in faith, welcome him, but not to quarrel over options, opinions. One person believes he may eat anything, while the weak person eats only vegetables. Let not the one who eats despise the one who abstains, and let not the one who abstains pass judgment on the one who eats, for God has welcomed him. Who are you to pass judgment on the servant of another? It is before his own master that he stands or falls, and he will be upheld. For the Lord is able to make him stand. One person esteems one day as better than another, while another fully convinced in his own mind. The one who observes the day, observes it in honor of the Lord. The one who eats, eats in honor of the Lord, since he gives thanks to God. While the one who abstains, abstains in honor of the Lord, and gives thanks to God. For none of us lives to himself, and none of us dies to himself. If we live, we live to the Lord. If we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. Why do you pass judgment on your brother? Or you? Why do you despise your brother? For we will all stand before the judgment seat of God. For it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bow to me, and every tongue shall confess to God. So then, each of us will give an account of himself to God. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise for the reading of the Holy Gospel, which is recorded in the 18th chapter of Matthew, beginning at the 21st verse as follows. Peter came up and said to Jesus, how often will my brother sin against me and I forgive him? As many as 7 times? Jesus said to him, I do not say to you 7 times, but 70 times 7. Therefore, the kingdom of heaven may be compared to a king who wished to settle accounts with his servants. When he began to settle, one was brought to him that owed him 10,000 talents. And since he could not pay, his master ordered him to be sold with his wife and children and all that he had, and payment to be made. So the servant fell on his knees, imploring him, have patience with me, and I will pay you everything. And out of pity for him, the master of that servant released him and forgave him the debt. But when that same servant went out, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him a couple of bucks, 100 denarii.